Morning at 9 on News Channel 8.
New at 11, a win for Buchanan backers in New York.
Tonight, the world premiere CBS Tuesday movie. How safe are your deepest secrets?
Tell me what happened.
Who's gonna believe it?
A girl trusts a counselor.
She was raped by one of the most powerful young men in Richmond County.
But will her secrets be revealed?
They want my files. They can't just take them away.
You said it was safe. I told you everything.
You don't turn them over, they'll throw you in jail.
Lindsay Wagner and Holly Marie Combs.
If my father found out, it would kill him.
In a shocking story inspired by actual events.
You refuse to surrender the records.
Sins of Silence, next.
Police brought her in about 2:30. She's been here 5 hours. Nobody can get a word out of her except she wants to go home.
What's her name?
Teresa Silvio, 23 years old. Some guy found her half naked in the back of her car. Head lacerations, torn underpants, scratch marks on her face and back.
No explanation?
She won't let us do the exam. Claims she had a car accident. Teresa, this is Molly McKinley. She's from the Rape Crisis Center downtown. I thought maybe you two could talk.
Thanks.
It's a pretty bad cut.
Yeah.
You all right?
I'm fine.
You want me to call someone?
No.
You want to tell me what happened? Don't have to.
It's not what he said.
Who?
The guy.
What guy? The doctor?
From the DA's office.
The DA's office?
He said I'm a witness.
When did he say that?
When I got here, he was waiting for me. He said I'd have to talk. He said it's a law.
He was wrong.
So I can go.
You can do whatever you want. But it's not always the best idea. Running away. You know, they just want to collect some evidence. You don't have to press charges. They're not going to do anything unless you say it's okay. He hurt you, didn't he? Yeah. Well, then do the exam, and if you ever change your mind, you'll have proof.
What's your name?
Molly. She'll do the exam. No statement. Who is here from the DA's office?
Joe Finn. He's downstairs.
What? You got the old guy there? Give him. Yeah. What do you mean, doctor appointment? No, no. Connie, listen to me. You cannot let him leave.
Joe Finn?
Yeah, because this is a very hot case. Yeah, and if I don't get the statement, then Andy McGivens is going to get the statement. And if he gets the statement,
excuse me,
just a minute, then he's going to get the case. And if he gets the case, he's going to be the next DA and not me. And you know what that means? You won't get your level A parking space or your 4 weeks vacation.
I need to talk to you.
Okay, that's great. For all your hard work. 6 weeks. 6 weeks vacation. Okay. Yeah. Love you. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. What?
You had no business threatening Teresa Silvio.
I'm sorry?
She could hardly talk when you got through with her.
When I got through with her.
Apparently, thanks to you, she now thinks that being raped is a crime she is about to be punished for.
Who are you?
I am Molly McKinley, director of the Rape Crisis Center. They called me in after you finished.
I called.
You called.
I called. But she seemed a little upset, and I thought she should talk to a counselor. You know, somebody soothing and level-headed, like you. You want to try this again?
You still shouldn't have pushed her.
Listen, Miss McKinley, I really don't feel I need to explain myself to you, but in the interest of saving time, we have got a witness, we have got an ID on the car, and we are this close to making a case.
She doesn't want to talk to you.
You know who that car belongs to? Thomas Franklin Bickley III. She was raped by one of the most powerful young men in Richmond County. Look, she's afraid. I know she's afraid.
You can't force her to make a statement. I don't care how badly you want this case.
Come on.
Leave her alone, or I'm going straight to the press.
Okay. You win. You want to protect her from me, then you go right ahead. I don't have time for this. Here are her car keys. It's parked out front. You tell her to call me when she's ready to talk.
You like it? I painted it myself. Me and a friend. She's more the artist.
Are you okay to drive?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Do you have somebody at home?
Sure.
Why don't you come talk to me tomorrow?
I'm not really a talker.
Might help. The thing is, some people are fine at first, but it gets tough. Nobody has to know but you and me. 10:30?
Okay.
Call the office. They'll set it up for you.
I was at this bar, Johnny B's. It's spring break. I'm only home for 2 weeks, and I saw this girl.
Did you know her?
No, but she was giving me the eye. Pretty soon she said, would I buy her a beer?
You had sex?
Yes.
When did you hear from the district attorney's office?
Menino called about 3:30 this morning. He said the police picked her up. They might need to talk to my son. There may be some trouble.
She want to have sex?
Yes.
Did she say so?
Tell him what she said.
I want to know.
She said put it in.
What happened to your hand?
Tennis.
Someone see you do it?
Yes.
Don't worry. We'll be fine.
Very serious. You must choose.
What?
Nothing.
You don't like it?
What happened to you?
What do you mean?
This morning, I wake up, 6:30. Nobody home.
I had school.
At 6:30?
Yes, cheerleading tryouts.
So you chop your hair to be cheerleader?
Just be grateful I was gonna shave it.
You have to choose. See? I make her today. Pink angel. Like you.
Sorry, the director isn't in right now. Can I take a message? Absolutely, Mr. DeFazio. I will tell her as soon as she comes in. Right. Bye-bye now.
What happened to the heat?
Oh, they called this morning. Right, Crisis Center, could you hold, please? They said that we haven't paid the last three bills.
Well, we can't just turn it off.
Well, they said that now that we've got a director, we should be more responsible for our finances.
Did we hear from Teresa Silvio?
Nope.
I knew it.
I wouldn't bother if I were you.
Teresa Sylvia doesn't exist.
What?
We got a call from Joe Finn at the DA's office. Fake driver's license. And the plates on her car were stolen from Henry Lee in 1983.
We're sorry. The number you have reached is no longer in service.
I told him you got the same number that he did. We said, thanks for your help. It didn't sound like thanks to me.
So I had my head in his armpit. No matter how we tried to move the seat, he was like steering wheel, belt buckle, door handle. So I said, I don't think we can do this. He opens the door and we go rolling into the driveway.
Into the driveway? Is that where you guys did it?
Where everyone could see?
Yeah, I guess they got lucky.
Grow up. What's with her?
Okay.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I said I'm fine.
Molly McKendrick.
I've been watching you for the longest time. I couldn't decide who it was.
First, I thought it was the Blessed Virgin telling me to start working on the garden. What have you found?
It's, something I left here when I was 9. All my worldly goods.
In exchange for what?
I wanted to be a saint.
I got a letter from the Mother General. She said that you'd left the convent. She seemed to think it was best for you.
It's a lot harder than I thought it would be.
It's not a sin, you know, leaving a vocation. Doesn't mean you have to leave the church.
I know.
But you don't come by.
I come by. I just can't seem to get through the door anymore.
I saw the light. I thought maybe there was someone inside.
Do you care if I smoke? It's okay if you do. I don't have to.
Oh, it's fine.
I should have a lung once in science. It had black holes. I think about it every time. No, it's not very nice in here. Should get a better plant.
You want to talk about it?
About what?
About why you came. Well, what's your name? Let's start with that.
Sophie.
Sophie what?
DiMaggio. I was thinking maybe I saw him after school. I was thinking he was following me.
Did he?
I don't think so, but it just keeps happening. I see him weird places, like I'm crazy.
What places?
This is stupid. I can't do this.
Sophie.
What's the point? I mean, it doesn't do any good.
It might help you feel less crazy.
Right.
Tell me what happened. You just try. You can stop anytime you want.
Who finds out?
Nobody.
I was at a bar.
Yeah?
I went with this friend of mine, and I see this guy, Tommy Bickley. He's in the paper sometimes, his family. He
starts hitting on me, and I don't like it, so I leave. And the next thing I know, he runs me off the road.
Why didn't you tell anyone?
I'm not stupid. I was drinking, 16 with a fake ID. I know what that means.
What does it mean?
But guys like him don't have to rape somebody like me.
Did he rape you?
What difference does it make? Who's gonna believe it?
I do. There was a witness. Even the DA thinks it's a good case.
It doesn't matter.
Why? Because you're afraid?
My father works for them, okay? Bickley Glass.
Sophie, you think they're gonna hurt him? They can't hurt him. If you bring charges, people are gonna know. The union, newspapers.
You don't know.
You have a right to stand up for yourself.
You don't know anything about it or my rights.
So go. If you don't think this is doing you any good, you should go. Sophie, this is about you.
I'm scared. All the time. Every time I leave my house. And I'm so tired and I keep thinking he has everything. Just like he always did. He has a life. Why does he get away with it?
I want you to forget about your father. I want you to forget about the lawyers and do what's going to be best for you.
I want to tell someone.
You're late.
I was getting dressed.
This registered? Next time, leave it at home. All right, here's the thing. You want to be careful how you tell this story. You can't lie, but you can't sound uncertain. And don't blame yourself. Maybe you shouldn't have gone to that bar. But you have to be confident, even if you're nervous.
I'm not.
Because if he thinks that you are, then he's going to start to waffle. You have to expect that. You just don't want to send the wrong message.
I'm not nervous.
Good, because you shouldn't be. Oh.
I can't prosecute this.
Why?
She lied about what happened.
I didn't lie.
You're 16, not 23. Used a fake ID, fake name, stolen plates.
You have a witness.
She was at a bar.
So?
How often do you go there?
What difference does that make?
Once a month, once a week, twice a week maybe. Why do you go there? To meet guys?
Sometimes.
Do you have sex?
Well, do you?
This is not a judgment. I'm just trying to tell you something. It doesn't matter what happened. She can't win.
It isn't about winning.
Yeah, it is. Look, why don't you just say it? He's rich, so he bangs me. So what? You know what? You can forget your stupid case because I didn't want to do it in the first place.
Sophie. Let me get this straight. Are you a good lawyer? Or are you just somebody who knows how to choose?
You can't take something to trial if you think you're going to lose.
Well, I think a better person would stand up for the truth.
Well, you got the wrong floor. This is the bad people floor. Good people are on two.
You told me you were this close to making a case.
I didn't know what she did.
She went to a bar, just like Tommy.
Yeah, and if Tommy came to me and said he was raped, I wouldn't take his case either.
It's pretty cynical.
Look, I don't know where you've been for the last 50 years, but this is not an easy thing to do. For me to win, I've got to get a virgin on that stand in a white dress with a halo over her head.
You came to her. You held out your hand, and when she reached up, you pulled it back.
Because the story changed.
She was raped. We both know that. You know, it doesn't matter if she wins. She wants to fight this. And if we fight with her, she has a chance of getting over it. She has hope. And if we don't, she has nothing.
Bring her back.
Not if you don't try.
Don't push me, Miss McKinley. If I'm going to do this, I don't need any more speeches out of you.
You okay?
I screwed up.
He'll do it. If you want him to.
What's the matter with me? You don't eat?
Not today.
You're one of those ulcer types, right? Everything is tied up inside, right?
Not really.
You keep your hands in fists.
I do not.
I saw you in the office. I thought you were going to pop them right in the jaw.
I haven't told him yet. My father.
Why not?
Well, because he thinks the Bickleys are like God. He works 50 hours a day for no money, and he says we're lucky. But they take care of us.
He takes care of you, Sophie.
He doesn't know what I do. After my mom died, he just sort of stopped paying attention. So he falls asleep, and I crawl out a window, and he never knows.
Do you want some help?
Thanks anyway, but I kind of have to tell myself.
We're not sure why she brought the charges, but her story doesn't hold up. We thought that you should take a look at these statements before things get messy.
He doesn't read English.
Read it for him.
Forbidden the car.
It wasn't the car.
16. For what do you need a car? So I can study, Papa. To get to the library.
Papa? Wait! What are you doing? What? No! No! Stop!
Let him touch you.
No, that's not what happened. That's not what happened to me.
Trouble. 10 minutes after I file, Bickley's lawyer shows up with depositions. 6 people at the bar say that Sophie was with Tommy that night and she was coming on to him.
Meaning?
Take your pick. She had her hand on his pants. She had her tongue down his throat. She wasn't wearing any clothes. 2 people independently have said that her behavior was crude. Now, did you even ask her what happened?
Of course I did.
Why didn't you tell me? What do you think this is? A Disney movie?
He beat her. He forced her to have sex with him.
You keep saying that, but it doesn't matter. Not if nobody believes her.
We'll tell that to Sophie.
No, you tell Sophie. And you tell her that she better start telling the truth. Because if they turn up one more lie, then that's it. It's her ass or mine. And I sure as hell won't be fighting for hers.
You never were.
You know what? I'm getting sick of you. Sick of you sitting up on your high horse.
You said you would fight for her.
That's right. Fight the most powerful family in this state. And if she lies again, that's the end. That's it. 10 years, my whole career. What about you? What do you lose?
This isn't about me.
Nothing. You don't lose a thing, do you? Thank you.
What did you think? They wouldn't find out?
I told you what happened.
What you told me was that he was hitting on you.
He was.
You were kissing him in a public place.
Oh, you think that's the same? You think it's like having sex?
To some people it is, yes.
I told him to back off.
Doesn't matter.
Oh, so it's my fault, right?
You're gonna make it look like it was your fault.
What am I supposed to do? Go home, pretend like nothing happened, act like I'm fine?
You can't lie.
I didn't lie.
And you cannot hide things. They're gonna find out and they're gonna use it against you. What?
I took money.
What do you mean?
Just once, it was a joke. Some old guy, he says he wants some company and he'll give me money. I won't tell them that. If my father found out, it would kill him. I'll lie if they ask.
Why do you do this?
Don't start with
me. This isn't good for you, Sophie.
Don't judge me.
I'm not judging you.
Some kind of pathetic kid, right? A real loser.
No.
You know, just because you wear blue skirts all the time and ugly shoes and no makeup and you think that's how it's supposed to be.
What about Tommy? Did he give you something?
What do you think?
I think if he did, you better tell me now.
Yeah, he gave me a trust fund. That's why I'm having such a great time right now.
Finish with these.
Okay.
Molly McKinley? Lee Keating. I represent the Bickley family. I was hoping we could have a nice little chat.
Why would we want to do that?
The Bickley family is very important to this community. I thought that maybe we should have a reasonable discussion before things get carried away.
Doesn't matter what I have to say. I'm not the one that was raped.
There's obviously been some confusion.
Well, if you're confused, you should be talking to Tommy.
Tommy's very upset. He was under the impression that Sophie liked him.
What do you want? You want her to back off? You want her to change her mind?
Sophie's a child. I don't think she really knows what's going to happen if she goes through with this.
Is that a threat, Mr. Keating?
It's a fact. She's been making some outlandish accusations.
Well, the fact is that my client was raped, and you can push all you want. That's not going to change.
Why don't you wake up, Ms. McKinley? She lied from the time she first opened her mouth. It's a subpoena. I need to look at her files. Session notes, appointment logs, incident reports. I have to verify her story. Now, you can give me those tonight, or you can give them to me tomorrow morning in court.
I'm not giving you anything.
You have no choice. If Sophie persists in bringing charges, those records are mine. Good day, Ms. McKinley.
A custody fight from an unusual source, the story at 11.
They want my files.
So?
Those files are my property. They can't just take them away.
Well, Sophie accused a man of rape. The Constitution says he's got a right to defend himself.
They can't take your files?
Well, certain relationships have been protected.
What relationships?
Doctors, lawyers.
Therapists.
Licensed therapists.
Sophie gave me confidential information the same way she would talk to a therapist. It's the same thing.
What information?
What do you mean?
You hiding something?
No.
Well, then there shouldn't be any trouble. You just give them the files.
Those are private conversations.
Well, if there's some reason why you can't turn them over, then you better let me know what it is.
I am trying to make a place where Sophie can feel safe, where she can talk and not have to pay for it.
Well, she's not hiding anything. She won't have to pay.
Other people have this right. If she could afford a psychiatrist, we wouldn't even be having this discussion.
Look, you can't keep those files.
Thanks for the advice.
It's against the law.
It's not a very good law, is it?
You're late.
Don't start.
Mr. DeFazio called three times already. He says you're going to pay the rent today.
I said tomorrow.
You missed your 10:30.
I mean, that was a joke.
She left something for you in your office.
I thought you were mad.
Mad?
About the money.
Sophie, no.
You know, you gotta water that thing. It won't just grow by itself.
I didn't want this job. I thought I was going to play hockey. That's how I got to college. Scholarship.
Why'd you stop?
Messed up my knees. They kept telling me to quit, but I just couldn't do it. I scheduled you a hearing tomorrow morning. You need a lawyer.
I thought you were the lawyer.
Well, for the state, I can't represent the Rape Crisis Center.
Well, I can't pay a lawyer.
I know somebody.
Who is this guy?
Why are you whispering?
Why would somebody who lives here want to take this case?
It's a labor of love.
Love of what? Joey Finn. Cuter than ever was. You said I would do it for free?
Well, not exactly free.
How exactly not?
You get to spend time with me.
All the right lines, every time. You know, I really just need you to explain it to the judge. You're telling me that I have 14 hours to prepare a case that has no foundation in the law.
Since when did you worry about the law?
This man could talk a nun into bed.
I wouldn't want to.
Excuse me. Do you have a restroom? Right that way. He's the only person I ever met who could date three women at the same time and get away with it. Let's change the law.
Yes.
What do you think?
And then she tells me she wants me to look less severe so the judge will know I care about Sophie.
I thought you were doing it for him.
Who?
That lawyer guy.
Finn?
I'd dress up if I were you.
Why don't you go like that?
The director of the center, a former Sister of Mercy, decided to put her conscience before the court order. In a formal statement, she declared the subpoena a violation of her client's right to privacy and refused to surrender the files. The judge has called this defiance delinquent and promises immediate reprisal.
Molly! Molly, wake up!
You lied to me.
I didn't lie to you.
You said it was safe. Nobody finds out, Sophie. It's just you and me.
It is safe. You're right here.
Why should I believe you? I trusted you. I told you everything. I didn't know you were a nun.
It has nothing to do with
you. You sat there thinking how cheap I was, and I was thinking maybe you're right. Maybe there's something wrong with me.
Sophie, I never said that.
Why don't you burn it?
They cannot take the files.
What are you going to do? Say novenas, light candles for me?
You don't trust me? Burn it. You burn it. Go on.
A nun? What kind of nun?
Sister of Mercy.
I knew it. That's the kind that doesn't talk, right?
No.
Now, just a minute, though. You got married, right? I mean, with a wedding dress, a ring.
Shut up.
What?
Will the court please rise?
Let me try to understand the problem here. 3 days ago, I issued a subpoena to your client requesting certain records be presented to this court. Are we in agreement about that?
Yes, Your Honor.
And she has refused to do it?
That's correct.
I trust you have informed her she is in contempt.
Her position is that the information is privileged and not relevant to the defense.
How are we to make a decision as to relevance, Miss Hayes, if we don't know what those files contain?
Section 6 of the Healthcare Confidentiality Act indicates records may not be released without the consent of the patient.
Are you saying your client is a healthcare provider?
Your Honor, I object.
Does she meet the definition?
The statute doesn't specify.
Is she a doctor? Does she have a license?
The language is quite broad, Your Honor.
Paragraph 3 explicitly defines the
My client's work requires privacy and confidentiality. They are both constitutionally protected.
Miss Hayes, today is my birthday. I hope it's not going to get any worse.
They're doing that hearing. Said it on the news. I was thinking maybe I should go.
What kind of records do you keep at the center?
Names, phone numbers. After each session, I write a couple of sentences about what happened.
Is it your policy to show those notes to other people?
Outside the center, no.
Why not?
Our clients come to us in confidence. Many of them are ashamed about what happened.
What if a client said it was okay?
I'd advise her not to.
Why?
She doesn't talk to me the same way she would talk to you. People express doubts in therapy.
What kind of doubts?
Maybe it was her fault. Something she wore, something she said. I mean, she might even say that the man who assaulted her looked too short in the lineup.
Because she isn't sure?
No, because when he raped her, he seemed huge. And her statement, taken out of context, could make it sound like she isn't certain when she is.
No more questions, Your Honor.
Are you going to be home for dinner? I waited 2 hours last night. You can at least tell me that.
It's your contention, Miss McKinley, that the information contained in these documents should be withheld from the defense?
I feel it should be protected, yes.
What if a client told you she wasn't sure who raped her, but she was pressing charges anyway? Would you protect that information?
It wouldn't happen.
What if it did?
Rape victims don't just randomly pick someone to prosecute. They want justice, not revenge.
Just answer the question. What if you knew that the man she accused was innocent?
You're distorting the issue.
Your Honor, this is completely hypothetical.
I want to hear it. Answer the question, please.
If I knew that a client of mine had deliberately accused the wrong person, I would step forward.
What if you just suspected? If you saw inconsistencies? If you thought, maybe she's lying to me?
I told you my clients do not lie.
What you just said, they get confused. I mean, first he's tall, then he's short.
If they're confused, it'll come out in testimony. The issue here is confidentiality. People have a right to a private conversation with a counselor.
And who's to decide if that conversation is relevant to the defense? You or the jury?
The Rape Crisis Center is clearly of great benefit to the women who come to you for help. Your passion in this cause is commendable. But we are governed by law, not passion. We are not free in this country to break the law for a personal cause. This defendant has a right to the records of the center as much as he has a right to the records of the police department or the emergency room at a hospital. I direct that they be produced immediately.
Your Honor, it's not the same
Miss
thing.
Miss Hayes, please sit down. I haven't finished. If the statute was meant to protect rape crisis centers, it would have said so.
Excuse me,
Molly.
Your Honor, this girl was raped. She's not conspiring with me. She's trying to get her life back.
Your Honor is completely out of line.
The center is the only place she feels safe. How can I help her get well if everything she says to me can be used against her by the defense?
Miss McKinley, if you prevail upon me to consider the facts, then you must abide by the decision I make.
I can't.
You refuse to surrender the records?
Yes.
Then I'm afraid I shall have to incarcerate you. You will be taken to the women's reformatory.
You can't sentence her indefinitely.
She has the keys to the cell in her own pocket, Miss Hayes.
Your Honor, this is unconscionable.
Objection noted. We are adjourned.
Thank you.
Training Better Fathers, the story at 11.
Do you mind? We can appeal it. Go to the state Supreme Court, petition the legislature to amend the statute.
How long does that take?
Months.
We can push it through.
You want her in jail? Is that what you want?
I'm her lawyer, not her conscience.
I'll be fine.
Do you know what it's like inside? There's one prison for women in this state. It's got drug addicts, killers, women who keep razor blades under their tongues, just in case.
You've made a decision, Joey. I think we should support it.
You support it. You've made your point, okay? 8 months from now, when you're still inside here, nobody's going to remember what that point was.
Sophie's not a point, she's a person.
And so are you. It's not a sin to change your mind.
You think it's my fault.
Is it?
Go to hell.
Why don't you tell me?
Tell you what?
What you told Molly. That's what you're afraid of, isn't it?
Maybe it's none of your business.
Are you hiding something?
What do you think?
I hope not, because she's in a lot of trouble.
Holy moly. Look what just blew in from Kansas.
Okay, ladies, let's go.
Keep it moving. Get in the van.
Lose something?
No. You lose. God, Mom, hey. Don't push it. Gets better down the road.
Get off it. I've had about enough.
Open your mouth. Wide. Take your clothes off.
My clothes?
You want it easy or hard?
It's been almost 2 weeks since Molly McKinley, the former Sister of Mercy, entered the women's correctional facility. In spite of protests from human rights organizations and local women's groups, Judge Boland shows no sign of reversing his decision. The woman's lawyer has applied several times for protective custody, which has been denied.
Turn it off!
Decided on the issue. Some feel that the Bickley family has applied excessive financial and political pressure.
Can I help you?
Excuse me. Miss, you have a minute? Publicity.
Lee Keating,
this is cold.
You know what? I'm talking to someone right now. Wait your turn or take it to the kitchen yourself.
I've got daughter your age. 16. Not quite so feisty. Must be hard on you. All the commotion. 14 days in jail?
12 days.
It's a long time to spend in a place like that.
What do you want?
You blame yourself, right? You're the reason she's in there? Big responsibility. You could do something.
It's none of your business.
Those records belong to you.
So?
If you turn them over, they'd have to let her go. It's your choice, not hers. That's what she's fighting for, right? So you can decide.
Mm-hmm.
You got a problem?
No.
You got a problem with me?
What do you want?
There's a kid in visiting. Says she's your daughter.
Because you don't want to see me?
Because this isn't a good place for you to be.
And it's not a good place for you either, is it?
I'm fine.
You don't look fine.
Well, who are you going to believe, you or me?
You should just give them the file. It's not that important.
I think it is.
I brought you something. My dad makes them sometimes. When my mom was alive, he said that they looked like her. And now it's her spirit watching over us. He says what you do is you put her over your bed at night so she can stop by and make sure you're all right.
It's beautiful.
I talk to her sometimes. Ask her to help out with things. I usually go to the cemetery, but I think you can broadcast from here, under the circumstances. I don't think she'd mind.
Sophie, I'm sorry about this.
I know. I need to talk to you. I went to see her today in the jail. They're saying they'll keep her there unless she gives them the records. The thing is, it's my fault. I told her things, secrets. I didn't want you to be ashamed of me. Did you hear what I said?
Doesn't he?
Why do you keep ignoring me?
Ma che? Non sto facendo niente.
I'm trying to talk to you. I'm trying to tell you something.
Per favore, stai zitta.
I went out sometimes at night. I got dressed up. I went to bars.
Sei una sfregognata.
I'm not what you think I am.
Aves onorato la famiglia.
I am not a whore.
Pensa a tua madre.
English! He raped me. You know why she's in jail? Because of you. Because I was afraid of hurting you. I'm Sophie DiMaggio. I'm sorry to bother you. They said the records are mine.
Technically.
I want to give them to you.
If advertising makes you nuts,
it's toilet paper with baking soda.
Then meet the nuts.
What do they think you're gonna bake?
Who make the ads?
I guess they're just trying to find a way to jazz up plain old toilet paper.
Hey, as long as they don't make it Cajun style.
These guys can sell just about anything.
Like walking barefoot through the grass. Now you can feel that freshness in your
Daddy!
Good Company premieres Monday, March 4th, right after Murphy Brown.
A good doctor, a loving dad. How did his daughter become Hollywood's most notorious madam?
Were you afraid of your own daughter? She's a good kid.
The Paul Fly Story, Wednesday.
See the world's hottest female vocalists on music's biggest night. Join host Ellen DeGeneres to see who will win it all for best female pop vocalist. Mariah Carey, Joan Osborne, Bonnie Raitt, Vanessa Williams, Dionne Ferris, or Annie Lennox. The 38th Annual Grammy Awards, February 28th on CBS.
this.
It's her right. Those were my records.
Soapy's records.
My apartment. And what gives you the right to go in there without my permission? What'd you do, break in?
Not exactly.
Yeah, well, I could sue you for that.
It's her choice, Molly.
She is 16 years old. What the hell does she
know? You better get this under control.
Don't you tell me how to act. Not you.
She was a little surprised.
What kind of a stunt was that?
What do you mean?
We agreed.
I changed my mind.
No, you didn't change your mind. They changed your mind.
Who did? Who's they?
The Bickleys, your father, Mr. Finn.
You said I should tell the truth.
Not your whole life story.
So I did. So what? I didn't rape anybody. I shouldn't be ashamed.
This isn't about shame. There are issues.
What issues?
Privacy.
My privacy. Isn't that what you said? I decide you want to stay in jail forever, right? All you care about is your stupid issues.
That is not true.
It is. St. Molly saved
the day. That's okay, fine. You want to give him those records? You just give him those records. But don't expect me to pick up the pieces because I can't. I cannot do it.
Punishing me, right?
What do you mean?
My mother used to do it. Starve and suffer.
Hungry.
Listen. I read the files. I don't think they're so bad. If Keating finds out that Sophie took money, so what? It's not admissible. It has nothing to do with the rape.
They'll use it anyway.
So we moved to strike.
It's a trick. You know that. The jury hears, they're not going to forget.
Fine. So we come at it a different way. Let him call her a floozy, a tramp, whatever he wants, and then I put you up on the stand, and I make it clear to the jury that you really know Sophie. You know what really happened.
Won't work.
Ex-nun, Sister of Mercy, for God's sake. What could be better than that?
Joe, she said that if anybody ever found out about this, it would destroy her. Now, she told me I wrote it down, and they're going to use it against her.
She's a tough kid.
Maybe she's not.
I used to teach before I left the convent, a student of mine, a girl, she came to me and she told me that a boy forced her to have sex. She said she was fine and I let her go and she killed herself that night.
This is not the same thing.
You don't know if she's fine. She doesn't even know.
But you can't quit just because you're afraid.
I can't sit there and watch them break her down. Please, don't go on with this case. Just drop it. It's not too late.
I can't.
Why?
I promised a friend of mine, okay? Wasn't a friend at first, but then she said something that kind of got to me. She said the only thing that really matters is Sophie. And if we fight for her, then that's all she needs.
Thank you.
prosecution calls Sophie DiMaggio.
I was going home. I had just dropped Dina off, and I noticed this car following me. It hit me, and I skidded off the road. He pulled in front of me and got out. I said, "What the hell's the matter with you?" And he said he was tired of me playing games. He must have hit me because I was bleeding. He said, "Nobody jerks me around."
What was he doing?
Tearing my underwear, pulling it off.
Did you tell him to stop?
I kicked him. I leaned on the horn. I kept reaching for the light. I thought if somebody could see.
What happened?
I crawled in the back seat. He followed me. He pulled down his pants and he shoved it in.
Thank you. That's all, Your Honor.
Top student, editor of the Law Review. I have to say that Tommy Bigley I know couldn't do something like this.
If he didn't do it, why accuse him?
People are hungry for attention. A big trial like this, it says you belong somehow. The system recognizes you. You count.
You think she's lying?
I don't think her story holds up.
Why didn't you tell anyone you were raped?
Because I thought I could get in trouble.
With whom?
With the police. I had a fake ID.
With your father?
Maybe.
Is that why you lied?
I didn't lie.
Gave him the wrong name, wrong age. Claimed you were in the car alone. Sounds like a lie to me.
Your Honor.
Did your father know that you went to the bars?
No.
Did he know you were sexually active?
No.
Did he know that you had taken money for sex?
Objection.
Sustained. Jury will disregard that question. You know better than that, Mr. Keating.
You didn't want your father to know, did you, what you were doing that night?
That's right.
What made you change your mind? Didn't you imagine your father would be less upset if he thought you were raped than if he thought you were having sex?
No.
That's what you told Molly McKinley.
I never said that.
You said it would kill your father if he knew.
Not about sex.
About what?
That I took money.
Order, order.
So, you didn't want your father to know that you had taken money for sex. And you told Molly McKinley that you would lie if necessary to hide that from him. Isn't that true?
I thought I would lie. I changed my mind.
No further questions. The defense calls Thomas Franklin Bickley III.
We were at the bar. Things were pretty intense. She said we should go to Gillen's Pond. She said I should follow her because she had a bigger car. So we drove to the pond. We parked. I got in.
That's it?
We had sex.
Was it consensual?
Yes.
No further questions.
You recognize these?
Yes, sir, I do.
Who do they belong to?
Sophie DiMaggio.
Do you know how they got torn?
I tore them.
You tore them?
Yes.
Under what circumstances?
Very nice circumstances, actually. We were both pretty excited.
Order. Order.
Where did you first meet Sophie DiMaggio?
Bickley Hospital, March 24th of this year.
Why were you there?
I was there to help her through an evidentiary exam. The resident said she'd been raped.
Objection.
Miss McKinley, the resident will testify as to his own opinion. You can't do it for him.
When you got to the hospital, how did Sophie look to you?
She had a cut on her head. There was a lot of blood, and she seemed to be in shock.
Did she tell you what happened?
I asked her if someone had hurt her, and she nodded. The next day, she came to my office and said she'd been raped.
Do you believe she was raped?
Her belief isn't relevant.
I'll allow it. Go ahead.
Yes, I do.
No further questions.
When you first met Sophie, what name did she give you?
She didn't give me her name.
What name did you write on this form?
Teresa Silvio.
This form also says she's 23. Is she 23?
No.
She gave you the wrong name, the wrong age, but when she told you that she was raped, you believed her.
Yes, I did. And so did the police and the doctors and the man who found her bleeding on the side of the road.
Thank you, Ms. McKinley. This note here, what does it say?
You're taking this out of context.
You read it aloud for me, please.
No prior physical contact.
Did you write that?
Yes, I did.
Six witnesses saw Sophie making out with Tommy in the bar that night. Now, when she told you that she was raped, did she tell you that?
She was telling the story in pieces.
No prior physical contact. Did she say that?
No.
You wrote it down.
I was making an assumption. She was terrified. She didn't want to talk to me in the beginning at all.
You said that she told you what happened, and you believed her.
I believed she was raped, yes.
Something in the margin here. What is it? A little mark.
Answer the question, please.
It's a question mark.
Question mark? You make that mark?
Yes.
What does it mean?
She was afraid that...
Afraid or not, you thought she was lying.
Objection.
Sophie never lied about being raped. From the day I met her, that story didn't change.
Ms. McKinley, you didn't believe her. What did you think she was lying to you about? Where she was raped? How she was raped? Who raped her? If she was raped?
Your Honor.
No further questions.
Tomorrow morning at 9 on News Channel 8.
Spend an evening with the Burleys.
Puke!
On the next coach.
Tomorrow at 5:30 on News Channel 8.
Pat Boone, heavy metal rocker, the story at 11.
Left pretty fast.
I'm pretty busy.
I can see. I keep trying to apologize. I keep trying to tell myself that you were right. I pushed too hard, that I shouldn't have put you on the stand. Or I should have just dropped the case, but you know something? I'm not sorry. I'm sorry I didn't do better, but I'm not sorry I tried. You didn't hurt Sophie, Molly. They did. You gotta stop blaming yourself and just get back in the game.
Organizing.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. It's been 2 years since my last confession.
What are your sins?
I let someone die.
Go on.
2 years ago, when I was teaching, she came to me and she was in pain. I didn't listen carefully to what she was saying. I sent her away.
How did you sin?
I didn't help her. I didn't want her to depend on me.
That's not a sin, Molly.
She killed herself.
You think it was your fault?
I hurt people, Father. Doesn't matter what I do, I hurt them. Every day I wake up with my hands in fists, and I push people away.
What she chose to do is between her and God. I doubt it was because of you.
I'm afraid.
What did she teach you, Molly? How can you live differently because of her?
I don't know.
I think you do. If it troubles you, somewhere in your heart, you do.
Mr. DiMaggio, I'm Molly McKinley. I'm looking for Sophie.
She go.
What do you mean?
The neighbor, she says she sees Sophie in the road. She has her bag with her. She get into a truck. I go to the police, but they no help. I don't know where else to go. She has no mother. I hear her at night, in and out all night long. I stay awake. I want to say something. I never do. I think maybe I lose her too. You know Sophie. You know where she go. Please. You help me.
It's 1:15 WRIC Richmond in the first few hours of a new day. Still awake? You got some troubles? No one to talk to? Well, Ira's here. And all here. So why don't you pick up the phone and give the bad dream to me? Line one, we've got Bob G. from Baltimore. Is that right?
I took something.
Took something? What do you mean? You mean you're a thief?
It was just sitting there on the counter. Nobody was looking.
Took what? A stereo, a piano, a color TV?
A wallet.
A wallet?
Yeah.
So, why are you calling me?
I don't know.
You want to give it back?
No.
Something's troubling you, man. That's why you picked up the phone. Bob, you still with me?
Yeah.
Maybe you should tell somebody.
I'm telling you.
Sure, but I'm gonna hang up, Bob. Then what?
I'll call again.
Somebody said they saw you on the highway getting into a truck.
I changed my mind. She was very sick, you know, before she died. What?
Nothing.
I'm not drunk.
I didn't say you were. What are you doing?
Leaving.
And where will you go?
I don't know. You don't always have to know everything before you do it.
You have a family, Sophie.
Oh, right.
He's very worried.
Because he doesn't know how to make breakfast.
Because he loves you.
He wants me to be like she was.
No, he doesn't.
What do you know? You're a nun.
I'm not a nun.
Well, you act like one.
And what's that supposed to mean?
You're a statue. Nothing touches you.
All right, you have a right to be mad.
Not mad. I'd have to like you for that. And I don't.
Okay.
I tried.
I know you did.
I tried.
I wasn't very nice to you.
It doesn't matter.
You want to know why? Because I'm afraid of things and people. Everybody.
I don't care.
Well, I do. So you listen to me. I have never gotten close to anybody. I worry all the time. I don't know what to say, or I'm going to say the wrong thing. And usually I do say the wrong thing, or nothing at all. And that's even worse. And I couldn't face it. So I ran away. And I gave myself to God. It wasn't good, Sophie. I was ashamed. I didn't think I deserved a life. Please come home.
Why?
Because I don't want you to waste all the time that I did. Please.
To wait up for my mother when she worked at night. He'd just sit there with the light on until she came home. He wanted to make sure she was safe.
Left, this guy came by. Says he's a defense attorney. He wants to see the records on Jimena Garcia.
Oh, I don't believe this.
It's a subpoena.
It's never gonna end, is it?
He said he wants to see the files tonight.
Did you do it?
Hey. He says if you don't turn them over, they'll throw you in jail. This is just gonna keep happening, huh, Molly?
How we unplug. It's the last moment of the day. Almost. We set the mood with some French vanilla decaf and head for our favorite night spot. As we start to unwind, the rich taste of vanilla gradually washes away the day. Sort of like a romantic night on the town. But we don't have to stay up past our bedtime.
French vanilla decaf. New from General Foods International Coffees.
Stein Ford and Vanderstein Toyota. Get the Vanderstein Advantage, working for you.
How long will the warmth last? My forecast at 11.
On March 23rd of this year, Sophie DiMaggio went to a bar called Johnny B's, just outside Richmond. By her own admission, this is something that she did quite frequently. Using a counterfeit license, driving an unregistered vehicle, she went there to pick up guys. Sophie was in the bar by her choice that night, and she met Tommy Bickley. She let Tommy kiss her. She let Tommy buy her beer. Six witnesses saw Sophie that night having a very good time. Now Sophie says that Tommy raped her. Tommy denies this. You have a decision to make. You have to ask yourself, which of them is telling me the truth? And as you're making that decision, remember this. Sophie lied. She lied to the police when they first met her. She lied to the doctors at the hospital. She lied to her rape crisis counselor. She lied to her father every time she went to that bar. And after she claimed she was raped, she lied again as to how and what happened. Now, Sophia said that Tommy forced her to have sex. I can imagine another scenario. Sophie had sex willingly. Tommy went home. George Gillum found Sophie half naked, too drunk to drive, and called the police. And now Sophie had a real problem. How was she going to explain all of this to her father, a sweet old man who had no idea of the kind of life Sophie had been leading? There's no case for conviction. There's just a question mark at the end of her testimony. You can't but have a doubt, a reasonable doubt, the same doubt that Molly McKinley had when Sophie first told her the story. And if Sophie lied so many times to protect herself, maybe she's lying now.
If Sophie was mugged or robbed or beaten, would you be asking yourself so earnestly whether or not she has a tendency to lie about things? I mean, if you found her bleeding on the sidewalk and she told you that somebody hit her, would you feel the need to examine the records of her therapy sessions? Would you think that she'd hit herself? Sophie lied. But she didn't lie about the cut on her head, the scratches on her back, torn shirt, torn underpants. She wasn't lying when she leaned on the horn and woke George Gillum in the middle of the night. She lied after she was raped because she was afraid. She was afraid that if she told the truth, she'd be punished for it. She would be disbelieved. She would be penalized because she's a little wild. And she was right. The defense has exposed her most private conversations to you. They've unpacked her past, mistakes, her self-doubts, every indiscretion held up to you as proof that she wasn't raped. And now let me tell you something about rape. It never takes place out in the open in front of a TV camera. It happens in the dark where nobody can see. And so it comes down to a choice. Which one of these two people do you believe? Now the problem is we can't expose the rapist the way we can expose the victim. I can't bring Tommy Bickley's therapy sessions, private confessions into this courtroom. The law protects him against that kind of an attack. So the only thing that you can do is look at the facts and ask yourself, is Tommy telling the truth? What about the dent in Sophie's fender? What about the stitches in her head? What about the emergency room report that lists her condition as victim of assault? Somebody hurt Sophie that night. I mean, there are only two people there, Sophie and Tommy. Which one of them is most likely to tell you what really happened? Tommy Bickley has been accused of rape. How reliable is he? Ask yourself, could he get up on that stand and tell the truth? In front of his family, friends, in front of a judge, in front of a jury, could he possibly get up there and tell the simple truth? Say, I did it. On the night of March 23rd, 1995, I, Thomas Bickley, ran Sophie DiMaggio off the road and I raped her, and I am guilty.
You gave her something today. You took it away and you gave it back. Chinese?
The only argument I can make is the same one I made before. You're a healthcare provider.
Won't fly.
A different judge.
They all read the same law books, Molly.
You have a hearing at 3:00. We can't do anything by then. You have two choices. Give them Garcia's files or go back to jail.
And what happens when they subpoena the next set of records? Who goes to jail for that?
Why do I even keep these files? If I didn't have them, they couldn't take them away.
Molly. Jury's in.
2 hours, that's it?
Mr. Foreman, in the case of the state versus Thomas Franklin Bickley III, charging him on count one of first-degree rape, have you agreed upon a verdict?
We have.
Will the defendant please rise? Do you find the defendant guilty or not guilty?
Guilty.
Don't do it, Molly.
I don't have to give them anything, not if it doesn't exist.
I can't advise you to do this.
Am I right?
You're crazy.
Okay, but am I right?
You're never right.
Ms. McKinley, how do you feel about what happened today?
I think justice was served.
What do you think?
I think it's time to go home.
What about the Garcia case? Are you prepared to go to jail again?
If I have to.
Quite a victory.
Thank you.
You could have some trouble at the center.
What kind of trouble?
Well, a lot of people don't approve of what you're doing. They find your tactics a bit extreme.
Stick around, Mr. Keating. We ain't seen nothing yet.
Go.
Susan Ann, 11286.
Got it. Next.
Arthur, 5588.
Yep.
Colleen Ball, 6685. Mary Baldessari, 41290.
Helen Mason, 5887. Elizabeth Morris, 7493.
Yuroko Sakura, 1194. Margaret Salvia, 12692.
Death Aruda, 61390.
Yep.
Kathleen Aruda, 71088.
Bingo.
I heard you were having a party. I didn't want to miss it.
Where did you get this?
A friend. He thought we should have it back.
What friend?
He's waiting outside.
And what are you planning to do with this? As a lawyer, I'm obliged to advise you that what you're doing could be construed as obstruction of justice.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I've done this when you told me to.
In an extraordinary development today, the Middlesex County Rape Crisis Center burned the files of over 3,000 current and former clients. Defense attorneys were outraged, calling the act a flagrant obstruction of justice. The director of the center said that until rape laws begin to focus on the perpetrators of the crime, they will keep no further record of consultations with clients.
Susan Colfax. Anna Marie Martinez.
Roberta Hansen.
Robin Jones. Jessica Harris. Lisa Lee.
Maria Hernandez.
Martha Gutierrez. Terry Baldwin. Debbie Mills.
Karen Green.
Coming up, Bob Dole comes in second, and Pat Buchanan scores a major victory, a win, and City Council gives the go-ahead to the easy run.